Hi, this is Fran with Little Windows Brilliant Resin. Let me show you what our cabochons mold can do. You can make all kinds of necklaces, from simple to elaborate. Earrings, cufflinks, cosplay accessories, small paperweights, drawer pulls, all kinds of fun things. This is our new cabochons mold. It has 6 different sizes of cavities. You can make any size casting from 1/4 inch up to 2 inch. There are multiple cavities for each of the sizes. And it's made of a very high quality clear silicone, which is flexible, and you can see your project through the side to see how it's coming along. It has a super shiny finish and an easy release, so your castings pop right out with no mold release needed. To give you a better idea of the sizes these cavities will make, here are some just clear resin pieces, and you can see the range. While this mold was designed for use with Little Windows Brilliant Resin, you can use it for other things too. It can take very high heat and also cold, so if you wanted to do things like polymer clay or candy making, things like that, you can use it for that too, but we don't recommend cross use. Your mold will come with a guide that has a lot of great project ideas and other information, like how much it takes to fill each of the cavities, and some tips on usage and techniques. Here are the things you'll need when you're working with this mold. You'll need a level work surface, Little Windows Brilliant Resin, some mixing cups and mixing wands, whatever you want to embed. I've got some glitter, some candy sprinkles, some colorant and papers, a dust cover, or actually maybe several. These are ones that come from our mold sets. You can use these. You can use any sort of clear cover that you have, even a Tupperware. Or you can use this slick sheet that comes with the mold. It will keep all the dust out, and we recommend having that on your mold when you're storing it. You'll need scissors, a timer, and some paper towels. There's other things you may want to have handy, things like Little Windows special photo paper. This one shows our photo cropping software in use. Some resin color film, and then also some colorants. This is our dichroic colorant. You can use glitter, you can use papers, you can use liquid colorants that are made for resin. You can also wait for your piece to dry and then paint the back with things like acrylic paint or nail polish. Normally, I have a bunch of projects going on at the same time, so I'll use sticky notes to sort of remind myself of what I'm doing in each of these cavities as I'm doing it. I've mixed up a 45 milliliter batch of Little Windows resin, and I've allowed it to rest in the cup so that the bubbles rise to the top. Most of them are popped, but I'm just going to take out these few remaining so they don't get poured into my projects. You can decide how much resin to pour in your mold, and that will affect how high your dome is. So you can see that one cavity can produce a variety of shapes. If it makes it easier for you to see your projects, you can put a dark piece of paper underneath your mold. We have some clear resin that I poured earlier that's already set up in here, and I'm actually going to take this out of the mold so that we can use this in another project. You can see how easily they come out and how shiny they are. To prevent bubbles, you need to pour down the side of the cavity. If you pour it straight in, air will get trapped under the fallen resin and create some bubbles in your piece. So make sure to just slowly pour the resin down the side. And think about what you're going to put into each of these cavities. These ones, I'm going to put little beads in there, so I need to leave enough space so that the resin doesn't flow over the edge. I'll fill these molds as high as I need to and then add my embellishments. This is a dry pressed flower. I can just float that on the top of the resin. Push it down a little bit to force any bubbles out from around the edges, but that's going to float on the top of the resin there because it's so paper thin. I'm going to add some dichroic colorant along with some pieces of color film I'll add my beads into these two cavities. And I'm just going for a random effect. The resin will magnify whatever you put in it. So anything that's left sort of close to the surface will be more magnified than the elements that you push down towards the dome. You can put anything you like into the resin as long as it doesn't contain any moisture. I'm going to take a little bit of my resin and mix in glitter. This is very forgiving, just add as much as you like. Mix it in with the resin. I'll fill a couple cavities over here that I plan to make buttons out of. After about 10 minutes, you'll want to pop any bubbles that are remaining or cling to the edge. It's really fun to do layered pieces in these molds, but it does take some planning. It's really helpful that this mold is see-through, so that once your first layer has dried, you can flip it over, take a look, and make sure that your design is coming along the way that you meant it to. We'll use this purple glitter to add another layer to pieces I've already started. And again, it's up to you to decide how much to pour in, and it really depends on how thick you want that color band to be. So this one is going to be an eyeball. So I've started out by pouring a very small amount of black resin to act as the pupil. And then I will layer behind the purple resin, and this eye will have a purple iris. You'll use this same layering technique for all kinds of projects. Here are some different examples. While our other little windows molds are better suited for photographs, you can make photo pieces in this mold too. The challenge is in avoiding and then eliminating any bubbles that get stuck underneath the photos while you're keeping the photo level. So the best technique I've found is a two-step process. First, pour a layer of clear resin and allow it to set for at least 6 hours. And that's what I've done with these. Print on the Little Window Special photo paper, and then you're going to cover your photo with clear packing tape. Packing tape is really slippery, so it lets the bubbles slide out from underneath the photos. Rub it down firmly, and then cut out your shapes. After this first layer has set, you can pour a little bit more resin in. Because the resin will magnify the image, you want it to be a little smaller than the actual piece. Just slide it in and use your mixing wand to push the photo against the bottom of the first layer. Now you want to sort of push it down across the entire image so that way any bubbles can squish out the edges. For this one, my picture of little Jack, I'm going to take some sprinkles and add those to the back just for some color element. To cut things out to fit in your molds, you can use a template like this that you can get at any art store. Hold it over the mold until you find the size that fits the cavity that you're working with. And then you can just trace over your paper or fabric or a photo, whatever you're using. Trace that and then it will fit inside. So this one is going to be an eyeball that has layers of color and glitter. But you can also cut out a photo and use that to make an eyeball. And with this one, I've left some white around it so it looks more realistic. Here's one that's already hardened, and I'm going to pour another layer of resin on top. Make it a thin one. Add my photo upside down, slide it into the resin, and push it firmly down onto the base. Little Windows resin is the safest epoxy you'll find, but if you get this on your hands, just wash with dish soap until they're no longer sticky. Another way to apply your photos is to take your castings out of the cavity, move it to a smaller cavity, add a little resin to the back, not too much, you don't want this to overflow. Then take your photograph, place it on the back side, and push it down into place until the resin squishes out around the edge a little bit. Now, with this technique, you can see it's best if the photo is cut smaller than the cabochon you're putting it on. That can also be done to add color to your cabochon. And the easiest way to color resin is with our resin color film. I'm going to apply just a small amount of resin. And then I have a piece of color film that I've cut to the size and shape of my piece. I'm just going to lay that on there. And you can see the resin just sort of flows to the edge. And it's going to attach this onto the base for me really nicely. When you use the resin color film in Brilliant Resin, the color is reflected all the way up and around the dome, so it looks like the entire piece is colored with a beautiful clear tint. After this, you can dome it up. You can also add glitter to the backside if you wanted to mix some silver glitter in. That's a great way to get some nice color. You can also paint between the layers of resin with acrylic paint or nail polish. You can mix glitter in with the resin itself, or you can pour a layer of glittery resin on the back of your piece. This is the doming up technique that you can see in detail in our doming up video. If you add the color afterwards, there are some advantages. The resin will magnify the glitter and it will be more sparkly and more dimensional. The other thing is this one uses a lot less glitter than this one, so if you're short on colorant, you might want to try this technique. Here are some ways to finish your piece or to add findings. You can drill through your pieces. If your piece is colored like this, you can drill straight into the side of it. And then if you wanted to glue in a finding that way, you can. If your piece is clear and you want to drill it to add a finding, you'll need to drill at an angle. So to get this started, straight up and down. Once your drill has a grip, you'll want to turn it sideways so that you can drill through your piece. That's made a nice clean hole, but you can see the white line where the drill went through. By drilling at an angle, you can add a jump ring or a piece of wire and it will hide that hole. If you had drilled straight in, you would see a white line from the drill mark. One way to make your finding really secure is to embed it in resin. So these pieces were all cast, popped out of the mold, and then I added a thin layer to the back and embedded the finding in that resin. For this one, we added the posts directly into the resin on the back. The same thing with this cufflink. This is a really fun project. These are doorknobs or drawer pulls or handles. And again, all we did was create these pieces in the molds and then add another layer of resin to the back and embedded the findings. Now these I got at the hardware store for $1.99. Using the resin as an adhesive makes the strongest possible bond. Or you can wire wrap your pieces or mount them in bezels. Rings are really popular too, and they can be made in a variety of ways using the techniques we've showed you. One of my favorite things to make with this cabochon mold are buttons. And you can see you can make them in any size you'd like. These ones were created by first making the cabochons and applying fabric to the back and adding a button shank pressed directly into the resin. These ones use a glitter that's not entirely opaque, so I used clear button shanks embedded in the resin so that it wouldn't show through. These use an iridescent glitter backed by our black resin with the metal button shank embedded. These come in different sizes and finishes, and these ones are all from our friends at buttonshanks.com. Here are the actual pieces that we made during this video. For the products you need, project ideas, and more fun tips, visit little-windows.com.